Is that it then? No more of that. It's getting too fucking easy, isn't it? Yeah, open the door, mate. You haven't got a fucking clue, have ya? Tell you what, keep it coming!
In the UK, I was obsessed with martial arts, absolutely. When I was growing up, it was something that I loved doing. It's a certain element of teenage men that have to do combat sports. It's part of our DNA. Not so much, you know, I mean, you know, it's changing and there's obviously different types of young men out there, but there's a certain strain that will get into trouble and will do things and will go the wrong way unless they have the discipline and the knowledge that comes with being punched in the face by someone who's bigger than you and then being patted on the back and sort of explained why he was able to punch you in the face. It sounds very simple unless you're a teenage man, you know, desperately struggling to find your place in the world and you need your chemicals sort of balanced in the right way or you're going to go off the track. And going into a martial arts, you know, dojo amongst all these older guys who are sparring and training and suddenly realizing your place within that system and that with discipline and determination and hard work, you can rise, you can grow in the same way that they are and, you know, proper role models and all that sort of thing that comes from it. It's an immensely important thing. So I was one of those individuals. And when I discovered the martial arts, I think I was at the local gym, you know, which is, it's like the sports center in England where they, you know, there's racquetball and there's martial arts on, you know, 3 days a week and then various different sports and swimming center. And I'd gone swimming there with some friends and we were watching Lao Ga Kung Fu, which is it's an inner city at that time. It was very much an inner city sort of type thing. It was not very highbrow. They wore black gi, which was different from anything we'd seen before. And there was a lot of sparring. You learn sets, obviously, to grade and to take the various different colored sashes. It wasn't a belt. But there was just a lot of emphasis put on tournament, a lot of emphasis put on sparring, a lot of emphasis put on the physicality that came with that, because everyone needed it. It's what young men want to do. They want to, you know, they want to learn where they stand. They want to hit someone, but they also, without realizing it, want to get hit back and put on their ass, you know, and bloodied and you grow through that. You learn through that and you become a better person for it. I truly believe that. So the martial arts were enormously important to me. They taught me discipline. They taught me so much more than simply being able to, you know, throw a roundhouse kick or a front kick or, you know, a, you know, elbow punch. You know, that was a, you know, a wonderful, you know, addition to what I gained and learned from martial arts. So I did that pretty religiously. I think it was, you could go twice a week, but then I found out that the same teachers were teaching in other cities and towns. And so I went, so I could do it every day of the week, you know, by following, you know, at the time, no cars. So it was train and bus and cycling, you know, bike in the rain to get to the dojo and train as much as possible because it was like a church, you know, sanctuary, certainly for 2 or 3 years up to leaving school and sort of getting into film. At that point, you're having to earn a living, you're having to pay your bills and, you know, things like martial arts for me, you know, by necessity had to take a back seat.